positions that license these occupations to provide for equivalent credit where a person receives training while incarcerated or in high school. So in some cases, it's, these boards and commissions are resisting giving that credit to these people. In many cases, they are actually set up to sort of be gatekeepers to these professions or these occupations and prevent people from getting in without going through unreasonable amounts of training and fees and that sort of thing. So the bill requires that these boards and commissions provide equivalent credit where a person receives training by incarcerated in school. Another bill that I carried concerns administrative regulations. Currently, strangely, federal law is this, it's set down by the Supreme Court. Lower courts are to give deference to administrative agencies when it comes to interpretation of their regulations and laws that apply to them. That was a 1984 case called Chevron versus some sort of natural defense fund. And then another case called Power, 1997, which held that. We had a bill that simply urges the courts to not give deference to administrative agencies' interpretation of their rules and laws that apply to them. We couldn't pass a bill because the courts are theoretically separate from the legislature and wouldn't be bound by that.
We were waiting on you, Justin.
How's it going?
Sorry, everybody.
So that resolution that urges our courts to not give deference to administrative agency rulemaking for the interpretation of the rules will be promulgated and circulated to all Supreme Court judges, court of appeal judges, circuit court, and chancery court judges. So I think that's going to have a benefit for Tennessee in the years to come. One bill that we passed requires our governor, to make a request of CMS, the federal CMS agency, and requesting a block grant to give the state the flexibility to fashion a solution to those needy persons who are uninsured or don't have access to health care. So with President Trump there, a more free enterprise CMS agency, we're hopeful that will be approved. Regarding CONs, some of you may be aware that in order to open a hospital or other significant health care facility, you must gain the approval. You must request and gain the approval of the government. Needless to say, that results in lesser access to health care and can result in lesser quality, I believe, lesser competition. So we had a bill that I sponsored that eliminates the certificate of need process over a period of 5 years. It would be a 5-year wind down. It was passed out of the Government Operations Committee. However, it's held up in the Senate where there are persons who allegedly are not so friendly to the bill. So we're going to work on that. It's still alive. We're going to work on it over the summer and fall, and hopefully we can get something done next year.
It's time to end the con.
I agree.
Thank you.
Another bill that I had would create a healthcare cost transparency tool that is a website which would accumulate data concerning costs of various healthcare. It would allow persons in Tennessee to examine the cost at various facilities for different kinds of healthcare and process by which law enforcement can take person's property on the, if they simply believe, have a reasonable belief that it's connected to a crime or derived from criminal activity. It's big business for law enforcement in Tennessee. We have looked at this process, and law enforcement typically takes, in currency, will take anywhere from $10 to $20 million per year from persons that they suspect are engaged in criminal activity. Now, a lot of these people, we learned, by the way, the average size of the seizure is only $2,200. $2,200 seizure is what we're seeing out here. That's not cartel money. That's not drug trafficking money. Many of these people, when they get their property taken by law enforcement, simply don't have the money or the time to go chase it down and go through the administrative process to try to get a return. And by the way, the standard of proof in these cases is only a show. The law enforcement is only required to show by a preponderance of the evidence that the property is connected to a crime. So typically, as you know, in criminal matters, the standard is beyond reasonable doubt. So the standard, when you're talking about property, is much lower. So we had a bill that would eliminate that, or substantially reform that.
It would still allow for criminal asset forfeiture. So if you were found guilty of a crime, they could still seize your assets at that point. But it would end the process of being able to seize assets, especially without being charged with a crime.
Right. So in many of these cases, persons are not charged with